Welcome to Music Museum Online. I'm Maciej and I want to introduce Conga. This is a true friend to me because I've been playing it for 23 years now. And I can tell you that it's a world of music, of different histories to discover only by diving deep into this drum. Dive deep, what I mean? For example, did you know that this instrument, the conga, even though it was developed in Cuba, it was brought by African people from Bantu, a tribe, that played yuka drums or bembe drums. The drums that they were making resembled of a huge barrel. As you know, Caribbean used to export a lot of rum because of the sugar canes that is so sweet there. And some of the barrels were given a second life by putting a skin on top of them and tightening them with pegs and fire. Later on, the system developed into metal hoops and special machines that tied the head to the drum. But the drum itself still carries the essence that was originally built for. The main idea of conga is to bring people together to perform a healing ritual that involves drumming, singing and dancing all at the same time during a whole night festivities, whole night, whole day festivities that are connecting the participants to certain African spirits and generally are bringing good energy and blessing to the people that perform this kind of ritual. So the conga only developed after it was taken out of this ritual and brought to popular dance music. But this drum is a very social drum. It seldomly goes on solo. It's nearly always accompanied by the other drum that's a bigger version of conga. So here we have conga and here we have tumba. The funny thing is that English name for the set of the drums is congas from this drum, but the Spanish name, the original one, is the tumbadoras, which comes from this drum. Cuban people have a lot of love for these drums, so they treat them like they're animals. So this is like a puppy, a little guy, and this is a female version. So we have macho and hembra. We can tell that it's also a man and woman. They are always speaking together. They're in a constant dialogue, and all of the rhythms resemble how Cuban African people talk and the rhythm of the life, tumbao. Tumbao, it means heavy on the ground, to put something to the ground, which basically tells you that when you're walking, when you're dancing, when you're just enjoying yourself, you have the tumbao. When you see someone dancing, say, what a nice tumbao he or she has. And how does this tumbao sounds like? Look. One, two, three, four. Every stroke has its own sound. You can write down each rhythmical figure into a staff notation, standard Western notation, but you can also say chipa ka tu kum pa kin kin chipa ka kum kum pa kin kin. And so on and so on. So this is a cool rhythm that everyone can play, and it's a starting point for many congueros. Congueros are the people that are playing the congas. And if you want to get more fancy with the drum, you can choose from any of the, I don't know, 500 rhythms from Cuba, all of the variety of rhythms from South America, because everywhere the congas are played, and they give the rhythm, they give the melody, the essence of each dancing style. Because in Latin America and the Caribbean, the rhythm is also a musical style and is also a dance style. So let's say if we want to play cha-cha-cha, we will play a cha-cha-cha pattern on the congas, but someone will dance cha-cha-cha at the same time. And the pattern goes like this. One. Like I said, you have at least 500 different Afro-Cuban rhythms that are hailing from Africa. You have the Abakwa, you have Bantu, Yuka, Makuta, Palo, you have Afro-Haitian music, you have Yesa, you have Yoruba, Bata music, Bamba music, etc., etc., and still it's only a part of the folklore. Then you have Rumba music, which is a mixture of different folkloric rhythms played just for fun. It's not sacred, it's secular, let's say, party music, but based on the sacred African elements. And then you have Música Popular Bailable, which is popular dance music, and it still is a mixture of Música Campesina, music that comes from the villages, like Son, Changui. You have music from the carnival, Conga. Conga. Conga la conga la conga la conga la conga la conga la conga. Mozambique, Pilon, you have, what else you have? You have Mambo, Cha-Cha-Cha, Danzón, Bolero. And then, on top of it, when you put all these rhythms into a bag, shake it really well, and add some elements of Afro-American music like jazz, blues, funk, R&B, and still mix it a lot of more and interpret it with your own feeling, you have timba music. And timba music is just gives you a headache, because there are so many things that are happening, and but it's so fun to listen and to play it. I love it, and it's a thing that you can study for your whole life, and it never gets boring, because Cuban music is all about the engagement, about the getting up and dance, about being together and playing something really interesting. So let me give you an example of how these congas talk with each other and form a rhythm of the same name, La Conga. La conga, 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 la conga. Thank you.